السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على السلام حي على السلام حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره وأعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما يا إخواني في الله يا عباد الله اعلموا أن خير كلام كلام الله وخير هدي هدي محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار والعياذ بالله يا عباد الله in last week the way where we stop or are stopping inshallah will continue بإذن الله تعالى from the hadith from Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is having narrated by Sahih Bukhari wa Muslim wa Sunan Abi Dawud wa Sunan Sahih Musnad al-Ahmad al-Aza at-Tabarani and ghayr zalik min hadith Umar ibn Khattab wa Abdullah ibn Umar wa Abi Hurairah wa Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhum ya ibadallah we was talking about the three men from Bani Israel from Israel when he was in the cave. In this hadith, we have a lot of lessons in the hadith, more than 18 different lessons we can learn about it. Ya ibadallah, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given to the Sahaba, and the Sahaba teach to the Tabi'in, the Tabi'in mean the student of the Sahaba. And then the Tabi'in, the teacher to the others, and then until now. We can learn about it, especially our community. Ya Ibad Allah, this topic, this hadith, the Siddat Rahim, Al-Afaf, Wal-Amana, the consciousness, the modesty, purity, chastity, and the demand of honesty and the trustworthy. The first one we learn about, the first thing we learn about it is your amal salihat. Your amal salihat for yourself. That means, and the rest, if you do amal salihat for yourself, the rest of the people, they do every deed. As a community, we will not succeed. We will not succeed. Why? Because the first one, when he made his dua, he spoke his history, and then he made his dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't take the whole rock. He just pushed it for a little bit for them to watch outside. That means your amal salihah can affect you. My evil deed can affect you. As you have to work as community. There was two in the cave. When the first one, he made his dua, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't take all the rock? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he doesn't take all the rock. Why? Because he said to others, they have to participate. Because if I did my amal salihah, or you do your good deed, and do my evil deed, we can affect each other. We have to work as one ummah, one community. That is Islam. Or my righteous action, my righteous deed, or your evil deed, we can affect each other. That's why the first one, when he spoke his history, Allah his dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept his dua, but Allah doesn't take all wrong. He just leave. He said to others, they have to participate. Ya Ibad Allah, we have to work as one ummah. I'm gonna say, I have, alhamdulillah, I have my beard on my chest. I have my wife, she wearing hijab, mashallah. My son went to the masjid every day, alhamdulillah, I'm okay. No, it's nothing finished yet, because you have your neighbor who don't pray, who did evil deed, you don't tell him to stop. You're gonna say, I don't judge him. Why you don't judge him? You have to judge him. كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةِ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنكَرِ وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made us the best of the nation. Why? It doesn't mean because we are nice, we are good, we look good, we are strong. It doesn't mean that. He said, تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ. Enjoy what's good. وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنكَرِ. Abandon the evil deeds. As community, as we can work together. And the second one we can learn about this hadith is what? Before I went there, the messenger of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was al-mujahid. He was fighting as muqatib in the battle of Uhud. In that battle, what happened? In the battle, but he was injured. Hamza, his uncle, was died. Mus'ab was died. 70 of Sahaba was died. Because of what? Just a small group of people. They disobeyed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't say? Because, you know, the Prophet was among them. Rasulullah came by after him. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was amongst them. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't say, this righteous man, my beloved man, this righteous man is among them. Let me save them. Let me give them victory. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't do that. But you know, we have to work as community. Because of that small group, they disobeyed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why the Prophet, he was injured. His uncle Hamza was killed. Mus'ab was killed. 70 of Sahaba was died because of small group. They disobeyed the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That means we have to work as community, as one another. Ya ibadallah. The second one we can learn about this hadith from the first story. What this man, his shepherd, he had to go melt a milk and give to his parent. So that milk he will give to his parent. Why? Because it's not wajib on him, it's not fard on him. He had to stand up, he had to stay steady to his mother. And his parents, they're sleeping, he hold the milk and the next day. It's not wajib on him. It's not wajib on him. It's not fard. He can just say, this is my parent, okay, I have to divide it as two and then put some to my parent. If they woke up, they're gonna drink it. It's okay. But he do that. He stand in the night until the next Fajr to wait for the parent. Why? Because he want peace Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the sunnah of himself. Be steadfast. Whatever you start, don't say, I start today. Today I'm give up. I don't have time. I will do double tomorrow. No. Even you start small thing, don't be steadfast on what you start. Just say, every day I can say, Kul hu Allahu ahad. Be steadfast on that one. That way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the Prophet says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Inna Allah yuhibbu iza amal ahadukum amalan an yutkinna. Allah love the work, the amal, steadfast, excelling on it. Remain on your deeds, even if it's small. Don't give up on it. Remain, that way Allah love it. That why the first story, when he had the milk, and then that time he was standing to his parent to wait the why, because his sunnah is where nobody don't drink before my parents. He pleased Allah. And then he don't want to break the sunnah for himself. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to the Sirat al-Mustaqim. Ya ibadallah, we have another, we can learn about this story, is what? A man, a young man, and a young ladies. I can say, this is big, big crime, a suicide crime for us. Why? We can think, the young lady, she made zina? I can say no, it's not zina. She was in need. When she was sufficient, when the young man come to him to ask him to commit zina, she said no, no way. But in case when she was in need, she went to him and asked him for that need. And if the young man tell him, no way, I'm gonna give you my money, I'm gonna give what is belong to me until I don't commit zina with you. She accepted. Why? Because in need. This is big crime. This is big crime in our society. Why? We hold money, we hold our zakat, we hold our sadaqah, we don't wanna give. We think Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us this money because of our power? No. Because of our smart? No. Because we are strength? No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you to give to others. As-zakat, as-sadaqah. And then you're gonna leave al-faqir, they will commit haram, they will do zina, they will steal it. If they steal it, wallahi ya ibadallah, ya ikhwani fillah, we will share that masya, we will share together. Because the wealthy people, they have this money. Do we think this money, this wealthy, we have it? We have it for what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked us, he will accountable for all of us. $1, 1 euro, or 1 yen, whatever you get it or you spend your way, Allah, you will stand in front of your law. Allah will ask you one by one, what you did with that money. So we have to give for the sake of Allah. That's why I can say in Asia, Tunisia or in Africa, we can go in a lot of villages, they become Christian, wallah. They become Christian, why? Because that village, they don't have house to sleep, they don't have food. That time, the Western people, the Christians, they went there to give them food, to give them house, to give them to survive. In the same way, they will teach them Christianity. They become Christian because why? Because of need. And we have everything today. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us everything. We say it's our power or it's our knowledge. That is not true. The Prophet didn't teach us that. Give for the sake of Allah. If He give, you don't if you lakum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who made that, He will forgive you first. وَإِنْ تُقْرِضُ اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا يُضَاعِفْهُ لَكُمْ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ شَكُورٌ حَلِيمٌ. The 1 yen, $1, €1, when you give for the sake of Allah, it will, in the day of the resurrection, you will see the small one you give is going to become as a mountain of Ur, a Jabal Ur. So why we don't do our best? Because you don't mind, we don't mind to buy shoes, we don't mind to change a vehicle every other year, we don't care to go to a movie, we don't care to buy $200, $300 to pay shoes for our children. For what? The poor. If you go to Dubai, or Dubai, you can see a lot of sisters, they're standing in front of the hotel, Al Bahrain. What they did, if you ask them where they come from, they're all 90% they're from Muslim family. Why they become like that? Azaniyat, Al-Bahiyya. Why they become like that? Why? Because on need, the poverty, they don't have it. I know, wallahi, ya ibadallah, ya ikhwani fillah, we will share that together. Me and you, we will share that together. Because we accumulate the money to put our account. We don't give the zakat, we don't give the sadaqah. The poor, the poverty, they will get up and they do haram things because they need it. Subhanallah. This history teach us about the young men and the young ladies because they need. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us strong iman. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر لذنبي فإنه هو غفور رحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يا عباد الله تقدم إذا قيل تنفعوا في المساجد Fasfahu, taqaddam ya ibadallah, taqaddam. Get inside, let them enter inside, inshallah. Ya ibadallah, this hadith, we have to learn a lot. We have to work as one ummah, together, get up together, inshallah. Ya ibadallah, what we can learn about here, the third one is me, it seems every person was who was using a masia, the man, the young lady come to him, he don't have money to pay her to do a zina or to do a masia. He don't have money. He get up to go work for her. 150 dinar gold. He went, work for her, get that money, and then do the masia. Get that money, do the masia. In the end, when the young lady spoke haqqa, when she spoke the truth, that hit his heart. And then he stopped immediately. That showed us never ever lose hope. Because our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he walked hard with two things, fear and hope. Fear and hope. To fear Allah, to have hope always. Never give up in your deed. Never lose hope in your deed. And then, the last one, what we can learn about this hadith, is to learn about honesty, al-aman, trustworthy. Don't say, any brother will come to you, tell you his secret.
He will tell you to don't say it, to don't tell to no one. When the brother leave, you will call another person, subhanAllah. 1 minute and then you will call another person. Yeah, this brother, he said that, subhanAllah. Allah will ask you about all those things. You will be accountable to all your deeds. And honesty. When the men walk on him, he hired people to walk with them. So the man, he know, he don't deserve that money. He leave. When he leave, he take his money to invest it on the business. That business become grown up. He have sheep, cow, and a lot of animal, slave, servant. And then the man come back after a year to ask him, my money, give me my money back. He didn't say anything. He just said to him, this all is belong to him. He was very surprised. But the man is not wajib. I can say it's not wajib on him. He can be, I'm gonna tell you something. Wallahi, nobody don't show me, but Allah is watching you. Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala, the day when his mother told him, nobody don't see you. Even myself, I don't watch you, but Allah is watching you. That day, from that day, when he went to school, the teacher tell the student, he give them candy. When he give them candy, he told all of them, I will give you this candy to hide it where nobody cannot see the candy. Every student, they start to hide their candy. Some of them went to the up of the tree, some of them hold the dick to put it inside, some of them went to the in the bed to put them. But Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala, he didn't, because he went home, he tried to put it in the box. And then he realized that Allah is watching me. He went to the in the bed, he put it there, and then he realized that Allah is watching me. So he didn't do anything. He come back in the morning. When he come in the morning, the student, everybody waiting for the teacher what they will do, because everybody hide their own position. So the teacher asking him, oh my students, why you didn't hide yours like everybody did? He said, no, I tried, but I know Allah is watching me. So I bring it to you, my teacher, to hide for me, subhanAllah. And then the teacher tell him, you are blessed children. Yes. Anything you did, Allah is watching you. That's why the man, he have al-amana, the trust wall, he give the money, and then what happened? He invested. The money is become grown up, and then the man come back, he give him all. That's why Allah accept his dua. We have to work as one community. The trustworthy. Ya ibadallah, the community to be strong, the relationship between your family member, your father and the son and the daughter and the mother and the brothers or sister, strengthen it. Something, you know, we miss something today in our Muslim community. Any community can be established, the relationship, the respect between the children and the parent and the family member, or any community that can be especially on the purity and the most chastity and manner and the trustworthy. Any community that have a good manner is gonna be a succeed community. But any community not trustworthy, we don't trust as today our community. Illa rahimahullah ta'ala. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't give us his mercy, we may be. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us strong iman to love one another. Inna Allah wal malaikatu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu tasliman kaseera. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama sallaita ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. Wa barik ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Kama barakta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين اللهم يحفظ المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والأحياء ومنهم أموات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين يا عباد الله يا إخواني في الله we have to walk one another because we have to put that in our mind my every day can affect you. Your good deed can affect me. Don't leave your neighbor or your brother because it's not my business. I don't want to judge him. No. But bil hikmah, let's walk one another. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless this ummah.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless this ummah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for our children. They are the future of this ummah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them. May Allah bless them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make them better than us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make them better than us. Ya ibad Allah, inna Allah ya'muru bil adli wa ihsani wa ita'i zil qurba wa yanha 'anil fahsha'i wal munkar wa baqiya ya'izukum la'allakum tadhakkarun. Akhir surah ya ibad Allah.